Happy Holy Wednesday. Now, at the beginning of Lent, this is the chapel we began in. And so here, as we come to Holy Week, we come back to this same spot. And Holy Wednesday, that might not be a title that everyone throws out there all the time, but it is Wednesday, and it's during Holy Week, so Holy Wednesday. It's a day that Wikipedia says is also nicknamed Good Wednesday or Ugly Wednesday in different places and cultures. But another common name is Spy Wednesday, a name picked up from today's gospel story, a story that sets the stage for the drama of Holy Week to come. The notion of today being Spy Wednesday was born out of what would have been happening around the Wednesday before Easter. And we hear about it in our gospel. One of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said, "What are you willing to give me if I hand him over to you?" They paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that time on, he looked for an opportunity to hand him over. The priests, the scribes, the chief priests, and the Pharisees, they were all people who had been looking and trying so hard, so long, to find a way to get rid of Jesus. But every time they got close, somehow Jesus ended up fine. They just couldn't pin him down. Until now. Until a rogue disciple decided that he'd had enough. Now, we don't have time to get into the complexity of exactly why Judas did what he did or how Jesus felt about the whole thing or any of that. But what I do want to consider is one part that we hear about today. Judas Iscariot decides that he wants to join with the chief priests in their nefarious plot, that he's going to become a rogue, a spy, and he asks the big question, "What's in it for me? What are you willing to give me if I hand him over to you?" he says, and they paid him 30 pieces of silver. Judas takes those 30 pieces of silver. He takes them in place of the Lord, selling him out, saying that there's something more important than Jesus. And maybe that might make us think, is there anything I would take in place of Jesus? In the past, in my life, what have I accepted to fill in that spot? Because let's be real, there are times and situations in which it's hard to stick by God and his teachings and the beliefs that go along with all that. So sometimes we might just find something or someone else to care about or focus on instead. Sometimes we do sell out Christ a little bit and take those few pieces of silver. The obvious response to that is, "Oh, that's not good." But you know that, I know that, you know, I think we all do. The hard part isn't saying that's not good, we shouldn't do that. The hard part is asking, how can I stop? And the beginning of finding that answer really has a lot to do with admitting when and how it happens. Taking a good look at yourself and your relationship with God and finding those things that get in the way of you and Jesus. Those pieces of silver that maybe along the way you've accepted as a replacement for actually nurturing a full and real relationship with him. In today's gospel, we get a spy, a man who became a traitor, but worst of all, a man who let 30 pieces of silver replace the Lord. Nothing in our lives should ever do that. So today, on this Wednesday of Holy Week, we might all take a moment to see if there are any pieces of silver in our lives that are blocking our faith, getting between us and God, to let those go, and to accept Jesus back again. Because there's no amount of those pieces that could ever come close to being worth it. No amount that will ever match the sacrifice, the care, the love that we're so blessed to be reminded of on this Holy Wednesday and throughout all these days of Holy Week.